Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, I want to thank you again, Lord, for each mother that's here today. I pray this will be their day. Lord, I pray that you will bless each and every one. And then, Lord, for our ones that are sick, the ones in the hospital, especially for Gary Blankenship, I pray that you'll be with him. I pray that you'll be with Judy today as she's recuperating with her back. I just pray that you continue to bless her. And then bless all the other ones that I might not know, or we might not know, that's having problems, might be having trials. And just, Lord, that you just answer each and every one according to your precious will. Now, Lord, I just pray that you be with our pastor this morning as he brings the word to us. As the preacher said, this is a church where the shout hadn't go out. Let's shout. Let's clap our hands and let the Lord know that we love him. And that's in the Bible. Clap your hands, raise your hand, dance, and all if you do it for the Lord. So I just pray that we have a good day today. I pray that at the end of the service, when we have invitation, or even before we have invitation, if somebody needs to know Christ as their personal Savior, I pray today will be the day that they step out and take that one step that they'll never forget. Thank you, Lord, for all your good to us. And again, I just wish every mother happy Mother's Day.
Amen. My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, when every breath,
joy at the work of your hand. Church, amen. Shout to the Lord.
Long before the fall of man, God designed a master plan. He exchanged the sinner.
Folks, next time we're glad to see him in the house of the Lord. And hi, everybody, I'm glad you're with us today on the In the Garden program, a ministry of the Gethsemane Baptist Church. Good morning, brother. Well, it's good to be in the house of the Lord. On a special day, it's Mother's Day here at Gethsemane Baptist Church, and my Lord, we got a church full of mothers, and they love the Lord, and they're praising God. They got the families here. It's just a good day, as always, at GBC, Gethsemane Baptist Church. Come on out and worship with us. You will just really be blessed, I promise you that. Address is at 411 Blue Ridge Street, right near the heart of beautiful Lynchburg, Virginia. One block off of Lakeside Drive. We're near the main entrance of Lynchburg College. We've been waiting for you. Hey, you better hurry up. You better get on over here. Good things are happening in this church. And speaking of good things happening, next Sunday, that's right, that's May the 17th. You don't want to miss. Tribute Quartet is going to be on this platform and praising the Lord. Two awesome worship opportunities, 10:30 a.m. and 6 p.m. Don't miss that Tribute Quartet. You've probably seen it all over a live TV over the last few days. Just come on out and enjoy a great time together. And now listen, we're going to be preaching today about mothers. Solomon wrote in Proverbs, he said, "Who can find a virtuous woman or a woman of excellence? For a price is far above rubies." We're going to be talking about that today. We are very thankful for our mothers, godly ladies that love the Lord. And we're very thankful today for every one of you today that tune in and watch this program. Continue to pray for us as we're praying for you. And come see us. We'd love to worship with you here in an exciting church. As a matter of fact, it's so exciting. It's a church where the shout has not gone out. Come worship with us. We'd love to see you. Now stay tuned for the program. May God bless you with the music and the message today. May your heart be encouraged. Hallelujah.
I heard about His healing, of His cleansing power revealing, how He made the lame to walk again, and He caused the blind to see. And then I cried, "My dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit."
Victory in Jesus, my Savior.
house of God. I'm going to ask the instruments just to be quiet a moment. I'm going to ask the instruments to be quiet for a moment. No instruments. We're going to use the instruments that God has given every one of us. Every one of you have got vocal cords. And it can make the most beautiful music that you can imagine. And there's a little chorus, and it goes like this, and I want you to join in with me on it. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Now give Him praise, for He is worthy today. What an awesome God we serve. Amen. Welcome to worship at Gethsemane Baptist Church.
It's only for a moment you were mine to hold. The plans that heaven has for you all too soon unfold. So many different prayers I'll pray for all that you might do. But most of all, I want to know, walking in the truth. If I haven't told you, I want you to know. As I watch you grow, your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you the courage to dare to do great things. I'm here for you, whatever this life brings. So let my love give you room, help you find your wings. May passion be the wind that leads you through your day. And may conviction keep you strong, guide you on your way. May there be many moments that make your life so sweet. More than memories. God would fill your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you the courage to dare to do great things. I'm here for you, whatever this life brings. So let my love give you room and help you find your wings. Start living. If you don't reach for the sky, I'll have tears as you take off, but I'll cheer as you fly. I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you the courage, dare to do great things. I'm here for you, whatever this life brings. So let my love give you room, help you find your wings.
I want you to turn in your Bibles to the book of Proverbs 31. I'm only going to use two verses of Scripture, and I won't keep you too terribly long, I pray. You know, our love today, we many times think that no one can love us like and as much as our mothers love us. However, you've got to understand today that our mother's love is a limited love. And we have today one today that that loved us even greater. And that's our God can love us far more today than anyone can. And we should not forget the love that we have in Him. Isaiah said, can a woman forget her suckling child that she should not have compassion on the son of her womb? Yea, they may forget, yet will I not forget thee. Today, I know many times in our lives, life becomes very cumbersome and very tough and very hard. And I know in times of losing our mothers and them graduating and going to be with the Lord, it's a very depressing and defeated time for us, it seemingly is. But I want to encourage you today that if our mothers have gone on to be with the Lord, they are in a place of a magnitude that you can't imagine. And if you are a born-again Christian, you have the promise that you can see them again one day. And as great as our mothers are to us, nothing can exceed the love of God that He has for us. But you know, mothers are important to God as they are important to us. The Word of God says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. And often when I use these scriptures, I will relate to the fact that when He speaks of being a virtuous woman, He's talking about a woman of excellence. It doesn't seem like there's a lot of excellence today in the ranks of motherhood. It doesn't seem there's a lot of excellence today in the ranks of the family. It doesn't seem there's a lot of excellence today in this nation that we live in. But we've got to remember today that God calls us to His excellence and He wants us to live in His excellence. And then Solomon went on to say that favor is deceitful, beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Now, for some time, I've been asking this question. And it started back earlier this year, around January, and King David made this declaration in the Psalms, and he says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? And we need to continue today to let those scriptures linger in our spirit and transform us today in being the people that God wants us to be. The family that is anchored in faith today can weather any storm. And so realizing today, and it's kind of a hard subject to deal with, you know, just to preach on mothers and just to preach on godly women, because it goes further, deeper, wider than just that. It enters into the hallowed halls of the family. And so when you talk about mother, you've got to talk about the entire family. And so as a family today, we know many times we do walk through these valleys of life that they bring to us. But, you know, if you look very closely, you have a shepherd who's walking beside you today who has promised, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. And I'm glad, as David said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. We have this promise from God. The family is an integral part today of our firm foundation that we build our lives upon. Unfortunately, today we are excluding faith from our families, our walk, our home, and our churches. And that really is why our nation today has come to the point and the place that it is in today. The all members of the family are under attack in today's liberal society. I have never been so amazed by the things that we're continually hearing throughout the pages of the news media and things that people are doing and the bold moves that they're making today that does not have God on it in any place or any capacity, but it has the taint of Satan and the taint of hell, and it has an oppressiveness today that surely is not of the Lord. Our world, our families, our nation, even our churches today are in rough shape. And folks, I'm telling you, we need a turnaround. Just recently, and I'm on one of the mailing lists for one of these senators, a congressman rather, and I got an email from him this past week, and it even stated in there, and he used scriptures. And I have never responded back, but this time I did. And I reminded him of this very fact today. And I also reminded him as a national leader that today, the nation today that forgets God is in dire trouble with God. And friend, today I reminded him he has an allegiance to the constituents that he today represents, that he represents them correctly today, and not by the biased liberal mentality today that's invaded and has invaded today in the halls of our government and throughout in the entirety of our nation, but he has today an obligation to stand for that which is right, that which is holy, because when he starts using Scripture, man, I'm telling you right there, he has already made a declaration to me that he believes the truth. Well, if you believe the truth, then you better start representing that truth, and this is what we need to do in our homes. We need to start, we say that we believe the Word of God. We believe the Bible. We believe what God has declared in and through His Word. But it's time today we stop just believing it, and it's time we start living it today and being the people that God has called us to be. It's time that we get God, His Word, back in our homes. The reason that our nation is frail is because our churches are frail. And the reason that our churches are frail is because we have abandoned the foundations of the Word of God today that is rock solid, is built upon the rock of ages, the Lord Jesus Christ, that will never falter and will never fail and will withstand every storm that can ever come. If we will get back to God and His Word, we can turn this nation back to God. Amen. Amen. I believe that. So that being the case today, our children and our young people today are being persuaded by a liberal mindset today to ignore, disrespect, and even to disregard parental authority. Well, let me tell you what. The Bible is still explicitly clear about the role of the father, the role of the mother, and the role of the children. And I hate to tell you today, kids, God has never, ever endorsed or condoned or today set you above your parents. Children are a heritage of the Lord, but let me tell you what, children need instruction and leadership, and it's time we, the people of God, give the leadership that is needed to our children. But today we also need children today to start living lives that are holy and acceptable. Let me tell you, anybody can go the way of the world. Anybody today can go the way that seemingly is an easier or a lesser way, and that's a more enticing way that is enticing today to your flesh. But let me tell you what, if you've got Christ in your heart, you can't go that way and stay that way, because God has called you to a higher walk today than the ways of the world. And women today are being told that men are no longer, you know, from the standpoint, your companion, but now that men are your competitors. Men are being told today, pursue your career rather than to provide for your family. And then we wonder why our families are in the condition that they're in. Our culture has embraced today a preoccupation today with self-fulfillment today that has taken the toll, and the toll that has been taken is upon the family unit. And so the devil today wants your home destroyed. The devil today wants your home demoralized. The devil today wants your home possessed by demons. And the devil today wants your home down for the three count and destroyed. But I remind the devil today, as Joshua said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Whether the devil likes it or not, it's time that we, the people of God, rise up today and start identifying with the biblical truths of God's Word and start living holy lives that are pleasing and acceptable unto God, that God once again can bless the home and the family. Amen. If we will get back to God and get back to these principles today, we can see a turnaround. We can see God do a mighty and glorious work. While our society is spinning out of control today, and families are fractured and faulty and failing today, and where today seemingly that which is to me is an abomination to the Lord, today is being glorified and exalted in the world and has invaded the ranks of the media and has invaded the ranks of everything, and even the church today is giving it the kiss of endorsement. Let me tell you what, folks, it's time we, the people of God, come out from the world and be separate, saith the Lord, and start standing for that which is biblically found on God's Word. Today it is crushing God's heart, and it should today to be crushing our heart to see the condition today of our world and that which is being glorified, which is an abomination unto the Lord. I told my wife last night, I said, if you think about it, all the voices that we've used to have in America, and I'm talking about the voices of Christianity, those who stood in the gap and proclaimed the message of God's Word and did not back down are gone. Many of them have died. And then this new age mentality that's invaded the ranks of the church today. And where are our preachers today that have the tools, the access, and the resources to stand in pulpits and proclaim just not nationwide but global wide the salvation of the Lord, and to preach against sin, and to preach today that there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun, and to preach today that moral living is the right living, and to take a stand for godly things? Where are those voices today? We don't have them. But I tell you, there is a voice in America. And maybe today those who used to do it are gone or dead or silenced or whatever today, or many of them today, just to be real honest with you, I think they're living in fear and intimidation. I think they're scared to stand up and say who they are, who they represent, and what they stand for. But I'm going to tell you something, friend. God has still got a fiber of people that is called the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if our churches today, if our local pastors, if our preachers today and our people will start standing up for what is right, vote out those today that stand for that which is contrary to God's word. Vote out those today that says abortion is okay. I'm glad these girls today, and many of you ladies, you made the right choice. Amen. God bless you today. And those who can't make today, listen, and stand for that which is right, it's time today they get off the scene. And we have the power that is called the power of the vote. And let me tell you, next year we got an election coming up. And I'm not telling you to vote for, but check out what they stand for and vote for that which is in concordance with the Word of God. Amen. Amen. Folks, it's time that we, the people of God, the church of God today, come up, stand up, and today start looking to the Lord and try. Well, preacher, we're living in last days and Jesus is coming any day. You don't know when he's coming and I don't either. But let me tell you what. I believe that he is coming until the day that he does come. I'm going to remain on the firing line and preach the inerrancy and the infallibility of God's word and stand true to the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, the cross, the risen Savior, and a heaven to gain. I'm going to stand true to what God has said in his word, and I will not back up, push down, or get quieted by it. I will stand for that which is the truth. The truth will set you free. Amen. We the people of God need to be the people of God. Amen. The word of God is powerless today if you fail to practice it in your home. Immorality, adultery, fornication, homosexuality. Now they call it transgender. Well, in my day it was called transvestites. It's wrong. And it's being glorified in our society today. Militant feminism today. Juvenile delinquency today. Sexually transmitted diseases. Teenage rebellion today. Pleasure-seeking parents. See, here's what it all boils down to. These are all sins today that have been hatched out of hell, and they are prevailing in our society, and people are falling prey to it. You've got to take your stand for the God of heaven today and the Word of God. And today you've got to stand against sin and Satan today. It's going to cost you something. But I'm going to tell you what, the blessings are beyond measure. And today, what is happening today, these sins, and there are two points that they have in common today. One, they are on the rise. I mean, over and over and over. And we're hearing the numbers and the statistics today that reveal to us the problems that we're having. Secondly, today, they're aimed at destroying the biblical values of the family. See, today, that's what Satan's been about all along. It started in the Garden of Eden. He wanted to destroy the family. And the Word of God is powerless today if you fail to practice it in your home. It's not just what you practice in here that's important, but it's how you live it at home that's even more important. Ladies, God's plan is what He created you specifically to be. He wants you today to develop today into something that will bring honor to Him. A godly woman is still today God's plan. Amen. And he wants you today to put him first. He didn't put in the Bible by accident, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. He placed that there as the plan today for the home, the family, the Christian, and the believer today. Amen. The Bible paints a portrait of a woman as being a successful woman, and that success is only brought today by the standards of God and His Word. The world today has a substandard set of values. If you're pursuing the world and your attention today is on you and the world, and today all you're looking for is pleasure seeking and all those things today, let me tell you what, your values are wrong. You're seeking the wrong thing, and I'm going to tell you what it's going to cost you. It's going to cost you destruction. It's going to bring you down to the depths of hell. And let me tell you what, God will do whatever it takes to turn you around. You better be careful what you're messing with, because God is nothing to mess with. Amen. He's the God today that requires righteousness and holiness. America today is being supported by the gods that are in Washington today, and they're relying today upon welfare instead of looking to God today, who is our supply. Let me tell you, Philippians 4:19 is still in the Bible. But my God shall supply your every need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus our Lord. A godly mother and a father today are supposed to protect their children, and they are not to allow society today to dictate how they are to be raised. I know today that it has been the plan today to try to manipulate and invade the home today and take control today. But let me tell you what, that's your home. Those are your children. And God gave you that. And let me tell you what, the devil and the world and the government has no right to controlling your home and your children. Amen. Bring your children up in the right way. Bring them up in the biblical way. I was brought up that way. Let me tell you what, I thank God for every time I had the Board of Education applied to the seat of knowledge. Yeah. I thank God for every corrective measure my parents placed on me. Because you know what? God only knows where I would have been today if God had not given me godly parents who loved me today and made a right example in my life. And who were not permissive. Don't get the tail wagging the dog. It's the dog wagging the tail. To use an analogy. It's not the kids telling the parents what to do and standing there and threatening you with a cell phone that they're going to dial 911. Well, go on and dial it. But you better be prepared for what you're dialing. Amen. Folks, today it's time we take our homes and our families and our children back. It's time today that we get biblical standards back into our home. And realizing this today, we don't need society to dictate how we raise our children. Giving birth doesn't make you a successful mother. Being a successful mother is when you are a successful example before your children. However, raising your children in the fear and the admonition of the Lord, I believe is the greatest gift that you can give your children. I really do. He said, preacher, you are archaic and you are living in the past. No, I'm not actually. I'm living very up to date. I'm very aware of what is going on. And let me tell you what, I was born at night, but I wasn't born last night. I very well know what's happening. And I also know I've made a lot of bad decisions in my life. And thank God that God's a God of grace and mercy. Thank God my parents had some mercy and grace too. Amen. Realizing this today, listen, Solomon painted the portrait of he took the brush that God gave him and he painted here as a woman of excellence. What is a virtuous woman? Let me just give you a quick pass and review here. A virtuous woman is a vigilant woman. Rather than spending the days reading romance novels and watching The View on television and all these other stupid things that come on that have absolutely zero value to you, and engaging in all this fantasy that really basically that's all that it produces, the virtuous woman accepts the realities of her life and she stays active in body, soul, and spirit. Amen. Vigilant. A virtuous woman is a person of confidence and kindness today. She's not given today to basically false humility today, self-abasement, and been kicked to the curb. Let me tell you what, they have a confidence and a kindness about them. Amen. My mother was a very kind woman, but she was a very stern woman too. Amen. I mean, it was even to the point, go get the switches that I'm going to whip you with. And then when your daddy gets home, he's going to take the strap to you. My God, I got the double blessing. Both below the belt line. Ouch. That's why, well, anyway. A virtuous woman is a giver. She cares for the needs of others. She knows that God is a generous God, isn't He? Amen. And that the gifts that God gives are good gifts and perfect gifts. And they come down from the Father, as James tells us today. A virtuous woman helps her husband. Amen. She stands with her husband rather than competing with him. Well, I make more money than you do. I'm sorry, wrong voice. I make more money than you do. So, go out and make some more. No, anyway. No. Amen. Pull that one back in. Anyway, support your husband. You're not competing with him. Amen. Listen, however God's blessing you and meeting your needs, praise the Lord for it. Yeah. Amen. There's nothing wrong with that. But don't sacrifice, hear this, don't sacrifice your home for a career. Because you become so wrapped up in it, then you forget about your kids, your home, your family. A virtuous woman is decorated with strength and honor today. To grow strong, you have to lose. You know, listen, you've got to lose this thing of the world. You can still be today in the position of femininity today. There's nothing wrong with a lady today looking nice and smelling nice and taking care of herself. Amen. And having that gentleness and that tender heart. Those are the real qualities today. You know, it's nothing wrong with taking care of yourself. But let me tell you what. Ladies, you don't need to look like Charles Atlas. I mean, we've become so obsessed today with us, we forget about our families. You can lose a lot, but let me tell you what. You can hold on today to the honor and the faithfulness today that, listen, in God you are rich. Amen. Solomon gives us a portrait of a woman of excellence today. And the sacred scriptures doesn't mention her beauty as far as her physical attractiveness today. But let me tell you what. He gives today and he shows us what a real woman is all about. A godly woman. He took the time to mention about this woman of excellence that she was a mother, a godly mother, a godly woman. A mother that was anchoring her faith in God, in the scriptures today. And believed that God is still God. Hallelujah. Women can render many services today, and they can do that to humanity. But the highest attribute, according to the Word of God today, is being a God-fearing, faithful person. That is your greatest attribute today. Honoring the Lord, reverencing or revering the Lord. And godly women, they leave their footprints in the sand of time. They really do. And unfortunately, many of the hands of our women today are not godly hands. They are not training up their children in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. They have abandoned godliness today for the things of the world. And they today have basically sacrificed their family today for fortune and fame. They have thrown off responsibility. They've thrown off honesty and morality today. They've thrown off integrity and truth today. And it's evident because, let me tell you why. That's why our country is in the spiritual condition that it is in. We've cast these things aside. And folks today in our society today, people think the only God that can help them is the state. The only God today that can deliver them today and lift them up. And let me tell you what, there's only one God today that can help you. And it's not the God of the state or the God of the government. It's the God that is seated in heavenly, in the heavens today, who is high and lifted up and is still in control. And is still the provider of salvation, the provider of hope, the provider of help. And is that friend that will stick closer than a brother. Hallelujah. It's the God who is the God of might and miracle today. It's the God that has the God of provision. It's the God who's the God of grace. That's the God I'm talking about. Amen. That's why our help comes today. It comes from the Lord. And there's victory today for your family, friend. The virtuous woman fears the Lord. The virtuous woman is an example to her children. The virtuous woman today is a help to her family. And God's portrait today of the ideal woman is that she is indeed a supporting rib. Going back to the book of Genesis and in the book of Kings, if we then go to the book of Kings, we find the Bible describes the rib and he describes it as a beam, B-E-A-M. And what he was talking about, and he's referring to the pillars that was basically that helped to support and hold up Solomon's temple. Now in the Hebrew, the wife is the beam. And realizing that she is that inward support today that holds up the husband and holds up the family. So ladies, you listen today. Many times we think, well, I'm just, you know, I'm at home and I just don't have nothing real exciting. Oh, you've got the most exciting thing going on in the world. You really do today. The portrait of an ideal woman is a woman who's a lady of honor. And friend, today, it's the wife today. Let me tell you, if she's not honored today, let me tell you what happens. If your wife is not being honored, guy, let me tell you what. Your prayers today are being hindered. The prayers of your home, the prayers of your church, and the prayers of our community, and the prayers of our nation are being hindered because you want scripture evidence? I'll give it. 1 Peter 3:7. Ye husbands, dwell with them according to the knowledge, giving honor unto the wife. She is not the old lady. Come on. You married her. Call all the names you want to, but let me tell you what, have you looked in the mirror? Because everything you're saying bad about her is a reflection on you. Well, the ladies love me. Giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel. That just means she's physically not as strong as a man. Of course, the way it is today, some of these women are stronger than men. But anyway, I'm not going to go there. They're going to these gyms and they're coming out, and brother, I mean, they, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, don't mess with her either way. Hallelujah. As being heirs together the grace and life, that your prayers be not hindered. When you're not giving honor to your lady, your prayers are hindered. Amen. The prayers of the family are hindered. And so therefore today, you may not always understand her, but let me tell you what, you don't have to understand her. Your mandate today is to live with her in an understanding way. Amen. Well, honor your wife. Treat her right. Remain faithful. Remain faithful to her only. Amen. And ladies, remain faithful to your husband. Remain faithful to your family. Hallelujah. Prayers are not answered. And folks, today, let me tell you something. The ideal woman is to have a loving leader. Men, Father's Day is coming next month, so you'll get your turn. But we've got to ask these questions as I draw to a close the message. How did Jesus treat women? I mean, how really did Jesus treat women? One, he treated women. He was a defender of women. An example is when the woman broke the alabaster box. You remember that account in the Word of God? You know what? And then they said, you know, she wasted precious perfume, spikenard, and she had poured it over Jesus, and Jesus defended her. Amen. Jesus was a defender of women, and he still is today. Jesus will defend women. And also, Jesus comforted women. You know, in Nain, the widow, her son had died, and she was weeping over the death of her son. And Jesus comforted her, and in that comfort that he brought, he even brought the son back to life. Amazing. He also, another way that Jesus does this, is Jesus forgave women, and he still does. Jesus forgave the woman who was about to be stoned to death because he said, you, being without sin, cast the first stone. They had to drop the rock and walk away. Folks, let me tell you, only Jesus can restore you and only Jesus can forgive you. And I just want to drive this point in today. I don't know what condition you're sitting in this church as today, and maybe you need forgiveness. Maybe today you need to be saved. Maybe today you've got things in your life that's not right. I'm here to tell you today there's a God in heaven who will save you, and there's a God in heaven today that will restore you, and there's a God today that will give you back your joy. Amen. But you've got to come to him, and that's what this 45-foot of altar is all about. It's for you coming to the Lord and bringing today your struggles, your troubles, even bringing your praises, and even bringing your sins, and thank God you can cast everything upon him because you've got a God who cares for you. Amen. Folks, say, listen, this is true today. And we realize today that we are blessed today to have godly women and godly mothers. Hallelujah. This is true when one generation of mothers today even throw morality to the wind. I'm glad today, listen. Listen to what the Word of God says about that. He says in Psalm 9:17, the wicked shall be turned into hell and all the nations that forget God. And it seems like God is about to do a rubber stamp on America with that scripture. Amen. We need to stop blaming the schools for everything that's wrong with our kids. Amen. We need to start taking responsibility of being the parents that God has called us to be. And your child is a product. No, they're not a product of their environment. They should be a product of their home. And I believe if you're training, yeah, they're going to make bad decisions. Yeah, they're going to do some wrong things. But let me tell you what. You don't throw the baby out with the wash water, do you? Amen. You love them. You forgive them. You be an example to your children and your family. There's not a perfect parent in this room. But there's a perfect God in this room today that will work perfection in your life if you'll let Him do it. Amen. I mean today, this God today, listen, He's still, this is the one that divides the sea from the earth today. And this is the God that even closed the very mouths of lions. And the God today that even in the place where there was fierce storms, He brought calm. He was the God who walked through the fire today. He's the God that turns night into day. And He's still the God that can take any impossible. Some of you are sitting here this morning and you're just absolutely riddled and overwhelmed and overtaken today with the word of impossibility as far as your life, your home, and everything about you. I'm telling you today, there is a God that can take the impossibility and make it a possibility. But you've got to come to Him and you've got to believe that He is, and He is a blesser today. He is one that will turn your life around. He is one today that will bring joy where there's sadness. There's one that will bring hope today where there's confusion. There's one today that is there for you today. Thank God that we have such a God on our side. So what's the secret of a virtuous woman? She is a woman who fears the Lord. That word fear means that she respects, she reveres, she honors the Lord. A virtuous woman is a woman of strength. This wasn't physical. It's today moral and spiritual strength. A virtuous woman today is ruled by the law of kindness, as Solomon. If you read the entirety of what Solomon wrote there in Proverbs 31, you'll see that. So what kind of portrait is your life painting today? A virtuous woman is a woman of excellence. We have to ask ourselves today, what kind of person are we? And what kind of home do we have? Is your home a home of hell? Or is it a home of heaven? See today, depending upon where you place Christ in your home, that's what your home is going to be. And I'm glad there's a God today that can turn your home, your life, and everything around for you if you'll simply come to Him. Would you bow your heads for a moment? As we close in an invitation and a season of prayer today, do you need to get your home back to God? Do you need to get your life back to God? You today need to just really come clean with God. I don't know what your need may be, but could I ask you this one personal, very personal question? Do you know Him as your personal Savior? Friend, I know the Word of God. I know the conditions that we're living in. And I know that the coming of the Lord is nigh. It's near. It's next. Look at your heart today. Does Christ live there? And only you can answer that question. If He doesn't today, I invite you right now, would you come to Him? What I need to do, Pastor, to come to the Lord? You need to do this first. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. If you agree with that and believe God's word pertaining to our condition before God, say amen. Amen. The second condition is that you've got to believe that Jesus died for your sins on the cross and paid your sin debt in full. Do you believe that? Say amen. Amen. Now the third question is this. Have you asked Him into your heart? Had I do that? Pray this prayer with me right now and mean it with the honesty and the sincerity of your life. Dear God in heaven, I'm a sinner. I just acknowledge that. I believe You died on the cross for my sins. I just acknowledge that. Your word says, if I ask for forgiveness, You will give it. Forgive me of my sins. Forgive me of rejecting You. Come into my heart. Come into my life. Save me right now. I claim this day is my day of salvation. Thank You, Lord. Head still bowed, eyes still closed. Pastor, I prayed that prayer with you a moment ago. I meant that prayer with my heart. I'm going to ask you to do one thing. I won't come to you. I won't embarrass you. I won't drag you to an altar or do nothing. I'll just keep you in my own personal prayer life. I prayed that prayer a moment ago, and I meant that prayer. Would you slip your hand up right now? Anyone? Anyone?
Thank you. Anyone else? Come on. Thank you. Anyone else? Praise the Lord for two souls this morning. Then how about the needs in your life? Is everything right between you, God, and your home, your family, others? Are there things today that you need to get right? See, friend, that's coming a homecoming day. The question is, are you going to be ready for it? Get ready and make your preparation today. Father, right now, take this invitation as we stand to our feet. And Lord, as the song of invitation begins today, homecoming day, take and use it right now to draw our hearts to an altar today that will transform us and bring us into the place of blessings, bringing today our families, our children, and bringing our needs and our burdens to the Lord, and calling upon a God who hears the prayers of His people and changes their lives. That's the God that's in this room right now. Bid your people to come. Will you come right now? Come on.